Thank you. spread yourselves around the back here.
Come in. Then you don't get one.
Welcome everyone to our special celebration today, and as we're about to begin the Mass, I invite you to stand and we're going to listen to our opening piece of music, Salve Regina. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And a very warm welcome to you all, to all of you who are gathered here in church today, and to those who are joining us in prayer on the live stream from elsewhere. And I know that there's a great gathering of people from all different places and walks of life and different parts of the diocese and Libby's life who have gathered here today, and you're all equally welcome. Today, as you can see from the front of our order of service, is our Mass of Thanksgiving for Libby's life. And we have much to give thanks for today. So as we begin, I invite you to sit. And first of all, we're going to listen to a very special piece of music which has been composed by Gilbert, and we're going to hear it played by Julian Gray and Ronald Pearl. Richard is going to come to the lectern with a very special tribute for today's celebration.
The Eulabi. Firstly, I would like to say something about why this is called the Eulabi, to provide some context. As you may know, the word eulogy is from the Greek, meaning good words. But as this is a very personal and bespoke eulogy for Libby, I blended things in a way that Libs was a very special blend to make eulogy. And Libs was always one to have a bit of fun and make stuff up, so I thought I may as well do the same. But most of all, it's a very personal way of saying some good words, but also saying thank you, Libby, for a life well lived. This is for you, Libby. Although our hearts have been shattered by your leaving, and every day I miss knowing that you are there, I have great treasures to rely on, that deep and rich fund of memories which are always loving and joyful. So I am sustained and my heart is filled in immeasurable ways that words cannot do justice. There are a few things that stand out in your life, and this is just a small and possibly random selection that made my bond with Libby special, many of which I'm sure are shared. These come from a wonderful life, a life well lived. I believe that Libs gave everything she had to give and more, and to use a football analogy, she left everything on the pitch. So when I think of you, Libs, as often I do, I think of how much you have done for everyone you have touched, how you gave of yourself, and how you converted all your pain and suffering into love and kindness. You were a catalyst for caring and a love amplifier, and in that way drowned out the noise of any unkindness that was around you and others. So for that, I would like to say, thank you, Libby. Your touch was powerful and healing. There was nobody who could give better massages than you. Your small but unfathomably powerful touch and the gentle hands have touched me and healed me and made me feel your love. Thank you, Libby. All of her children, and I hope that doesn't need to be explained that she had many children, but I want to say how lucky and privileged my sister Isabel and I were to be the first, but by no means the last. We benefited from your undivided attention, but your generosity knew no bounds and it never depleted the love that I felt from you. Thank you, Libby. As one of your children, I will always feel the memory of you stroking me with your long, beautifully painted fingernails. It was such a pleasure. Thank you, Libby. And in a completely intangible but utterly concrete way, I know that you made me a better person just by you being my auntie, and the most special auntie at that. I am proud to be called your nephew. Thank you, Libby. You also had some special powers, and for those I have special thanks. You made sure that my life would be happy and fulfilled by directing Ness towards me, with whom the last 28 years would not have been the same, and not have led me to the meaningful and fulfilled life, one in which I've been able to create the most special relationships with wonderful people, of whom you were so proud. More than anything, thank you, Libby. And for being the best sister to my mum, especially after my dad died. Thank you, Libby. I will always be in awe of your limitless compassion. On the day that you left us, you were tirelessly, selflessly, and without flinching, going to do what you always did, thinking of others and giving your love and kindness to those who needed and were nourished by it. Thank you, Libby. Your love, and it is all that really matters, was a practical, everyday torrent, felt whether I was near you or far. Thank you, Libby. Your humour was unbounded and maybe a little unhinged. Your decision during a game of charades is now enshrined in family legend, when you decided to go totally off-piste and do a mime for lasagna with hand gestures. For that and a myriad other wonderful and unique memories, I thank you, Libby. And because I can't help put another film reference in, I don't know if you noticed the previous one, you have made the great escape from this world, and I hope that you are somewhere with your lovely motorcycling bow. You honoured us all with your life. Thank you, Libby. You enriched us all beyond measure and words. Thank you, Libby. And also, because it can't be said enough, for your wonderful life, a life well lived, and all that you gave to us is forever. And if you want to join me, please say, thank you, Libby.
Let us stand. Coming together as God's family, with confidence, let us ask the Father's forgiveness, for he is full of gentleness and compassion. Lord Jesus, you were lifted up to draw all people to yourself. Lord, have mercy. You shouldered the cross to bear our suffering and sinfulness. Christ, have mercy. You open for your people the way from death to life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Incline your ear, O Lord, to our prayers, by which we humbly entreat your mercy, that as you graciously numbered your servant Libby among your people in this world, you may now set her in a place of peace and light, and grant her a share in the company of your saints. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated, as we're going to hear now from the Word of God, read by Jessica.
A reading from Corinthians. Though I command languages, both human and angelic, if I speak without love, I am no more than a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. And though I have the power of prophecy to penetrate all mysteries and knowledge, and though I have all the faith necessary to move mountains, if I am without love, I am nothing. Though I should give away to the poor all that I possess, and even give up my body to be burned, if I am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. Love is never jealous. Love is not boastful or conceited. It is never rude and never seeks its own advantage. It does not take offense or store up grievances. Love does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but finds its joy in the truth. It is always ready to make allowances, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love never comes to an end. But if there are prophecies, they will be done away with. If tongues, they will fall silent. And if knowledge, it will be done away with. For we know only imperfectly, and we prophesy imperfectly. But once perfection comes, all imperfect things will be done away with. When I was a child, I used to talk like a child, and see things as a child does, and think like a child. But now that I have become an adult, I have finished with all childish ways. Now we see only reflections in a mirror, mere riddles, but then we shall be seeing face to face. Now I can know only imperfectly, but then I shall know just as fully as I am myself known. As it is, these remain. Faith, hope, love, the three of them, and the greatest of them is love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us stand, and we're going to join in singing our responsorial psalm.
Thank you. Alleluia, alleluia. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus exclaimed, I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever, and revealing them to mere children. For that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy, and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Well, a very warm welcome to you all once again, and a special welcome, of course, to Libby's family. I also want to welcome Father Tom and Father David, who are joining us for our Mass today. And all of you, Libby's friends, members of the parish, and visitors from elsewhere, you're all really welcome as we gather together to celebrate this Mass of Thanksgiving. And it really is our opportunity to celebrate and to say thank you. So, after everything that's happened, I hope that all of you find this a consoling and I think even an uplifting experience as we gather together in prayer and in thanksgiving for Libby. It was lovely to hear that lovely tribute led by Richard, in which we were able to hear and to join in time and again, thank you, Libby. And this is really the prayer at the heart of our celebration today. At the end of the funeral mass, the priest always prays, we give you thanks, Almighty God, for the blessings which you bestowed on Libby in her life. They are signs to us of your goodness. And how true that is. The blessings of Libby's life are signs to us of how good God is. And so in our prayer, in the Eucharist, this act of thanksgiving today, we thank God for the many blessings in Libby's life and for the gift that she was, the gift that she continues to be for all of us. I know that all of you here, the reason you're here is you all have something of your own in your heart and in your soul to give thanks for today. And so all of these thanksgivings gather together into this great prayer, which becomes the Eucharist, this great prayer of thanksgiving to God for Jesus having been raised from the dead. So we really, really are united in a beautiful and a spiritual sense. When I first found out I was going to come to Our Lady of Lourdes in New Southgate, I didn't really know very much about it. Looked in the yearbook, rang Father Tom, and a few days later I came over to see him in the presbytery, and he said, well, I'll show you around. So we went downstairs, and Father Tom was showing me all the different places. I thought, this place is huge, I'll never work it out. And we went into the hall, and who was there but Libby? So she was the first parishioner of Our Lady of Lourdes who I met after I found out I'd been appointed here. And of course, she was in full cry, full flow, in action, in the hall. And so I thought, okay. And it was lovely to see her and to meet her and to see what she was doing. And I think every time I met her after that, it was the same. She was a doer, wasn't she? a real doer. And I was thinking about that this week when it happened. I was at a meeting about the forthcoming synod. And I was thinking to myself, this is odd, because here we are having a meeting about a meeting. And you know, there's a lot of this in the church, a lot of talking, and people love to have meetings. I'm not too keen on them myself. I think perhaps Libby felt the same, because she wasn't really interested in the talking about doing things. She was interested in doing them. And you know, we heard that lovely reading from St. Paul, where he reflects at the end that ultimately there are only three things that last: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of them is love. And Libby really was the personification of love in action. It struck me that she didn't waste time talking about it or thinking about it. She simply did it. And that is a wonderful example for all of us. And I'm preaching to myself here too, that what God needs is doers. People who put into action the love that he has already revealed to us. She reached out to everyone, and that was how she became love in action. She was a dynamo, really, of love in action. When I was thinking about her life and what I was going to say today, some words of the gospel kept on coming back to me. And we haven't heard them today, but they're the words that Jesus speaks to his disciples near the end, when he says to them, "You did not choose me. No, I chose you. And I commissioned you to go out and to bear fruit, fruit that will last." Now, of course, those words are addressed to the disciples, but they're also addressed to us too, because we are Christ's followers and friends today. And the words of Jesus apply to us. We did not choose him. He has already chosen us, and he is the one who has commissioned us to go out and to bear fruit, fruit that will last. And really, at the heart of today's celebration, we are conscious of that tangible fruit that was brought forth through God's grace in Libby's life. And it wasn't just a passing thing that is being forgotten about or doesn't exist anymore. Look at the church today. What Libby did through her wonderful life and the manner of her living and loving was she was able, through God's grace, to bring about fruit. And it's fruit that still lasts and that we still can benefit from and celebrate, and we want to hang on to and continue. And so that really is a beautiful thing at the heart of this Mass of Thanksgiving, that we're still benefiting from and still enjoying everything that she did and everything that she was and that she continues to be for us even now. And finally today, of course, we want to pray to Almighty God, and we want to ask him to take care of her and to bring her in all of his love and goodness into his heavenly kingdom. And I think we can be certain that that prayer that we make today will surely be answered. So I invite you to stand, and now we're going to pray to Almighty God. Vanessa and Luke and Diran and Nurasita and Laura are going to come forward. Lara, sorry. So with hearts full of faith and love, we bring our prayers to Almighty God.
We pray that the Saturday clubs continue to flourish even in Libby's absence. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray that the governments of the world come to realise that there is an urgency to restore peace in the world so all violence stops. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray that our relatives and friends who have gone before us may enjoy unending peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray that all those who cared for Libby, including the paramedics and staff at Barnet Hospital, be blessed for their efforts and their service to others. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, help us to comfort one another in our grief, finding light and companionship in times of darkness, and faith in times of doubt. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray that all of us here today may renew our appreciation for the gift of life. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. And let us commend Libby and all of God's people, living and dead, to the intercession of Our Lady, as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Father in heaven, hear all of the prayers that are brought to this celebration today, in thanksgiving, with love and affection in our hearts, and grant what we ask through Christ our risen Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Let us stand and pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favour, O Lord, on your servant Libby, for whom we offer you the sacrifice of praise, humbly entreating that, reconciled with you through these devoted offices, she may merit to rise again to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, and the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one Spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church in earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, and Vincent our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you gain for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant Libby, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Let us stand. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of
God,
Jesus Christ, be eternal life to us received. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. During the communion procession, we're going to listen to Panis Angelicus, played by John. Thank you. body of Christ.
Amen.
And now for our reflection after communion, we're going to listen to Ave Maria.